Censored, America is up for sale. Hi, welcome to China Uncensored, I'm Chris Chappell. Now, for years, people have been saying China isn't ready for democracy. But if the U.S. keeps supporting China's brutal Communist Party with our businesses, jobs, and money, China will end up with more freedom. That makes total sense. But it turns out, all we've really been doing is supporting China's brutal Communist Party, and they don't seem too fond of the idea of democracy. The U.S. owes China $1.17 trillion, pays about $100 million a day in interest on that, and according to the U.S. Census Bureau, in 2012, the U.S. had a $300 billion trade deficit with China, the largest trade deficit any country ever has had, ever in history. Now, while this might scare some people, the U.S. has a few tricks up its sleeves. The U.S. has allowed its economy to tank so hard that now the value of the dollar is plummeting. So who cares how many trillions of dollars of debt China owns? Looks like the U.S. has pulled the wool over the old Communist Party's eyes. But even as the American economy suffers, there's still some who want to buy American. China. All across the country, the Chinese government or Chinese companies, which for the most part are owned or linked to the Chinese government, have been buying up bits and pieces of America. Real estate, infrastructure, businesses, homes, farmland, natural resources, oil. According to the Rhodium Group, an investment monitoring company that focuses on China, in 2012, Chinese investment in the U.S. was $6.5 billion, whereas in 2009, it was only $1.9 billion, and before that, it wasn't even a billion. So, where exactly is this money going? Well, some people are concerned that Sinomac, which the Chinese government owns most of, is trying to establish special economic zones, just like they have in China, right in the middle of America. Shenzhen was just a tiny fishing village in the 70s before it was designated a special economic zone. And look at the workers' paradise it's become now. I mean, America's very own Shenzhen. Who wouldn't want that? Here's another one. In May of 2012, Sino-Michigan Properties LLC bought up 200 acres of land near the town of Milan, Michigan. But come on, it's not like they're going to build a Chinese city in the middle of America, right? Actually, that's exactly what the plan was. They had plans to build an entire city complete with lakes and a cultural center catered to Chinese businessmen who want to start companies in the U.S. just 40 minutes away from Detroit. It hit a little snag when they found out it wasn't legally possible to bring in that many Chinese immigrants and still be profitable with current immigration laws. Then there's the China Ocean Shipping Company that owns vital ports on both coasts, which you'd think if U.S. citizens can now be sentenced to indefinite detention without trial under the National Defense Authorization Act, the U.S. government would give at least equal weight to a possible conflict of interest that could be created by a communist country that flouts the rule of law owning vital ports! The problem is very little reporting is done about these topics, so it's really hard to know what the latest developments are. But is there a real threat? Well, the U.S. Congress apparently thinks Chinese companies could present a huge threat. In October 2012, a U.S. House Intelligence Committee found that Chinese telecommunication companies Huawei and ZTE operations in the U.S. were a, quote, threat to national security interests. Of course, that didn't stop China's largest auto parts maker from buying U.S. A123 systems in January. They make electronic car batteries and had a couple of big military contracts. So, sure, that might transfer sensitive technology used by the U.S. military, developed with U.S. taxpayer money, into the hands of the Chinese government, but, I mean, they're our allies, right? Since former U.S. President Bill Clinton signed a trade deal with ex-Chinese leader Jiang Zemin, who, by the way, at the time was orchestrating a genocide against 100 million Falun Gong practitioners in China, the U.S. has found itself with a $2.5 trillion trade deficit. Maybe that wasn't such a good idea. It's funny, in a way, because the U.S. has pumped so much money into the Chinese Communist Party directly or through its subsidiaries, it's almost like the U.S. is funding all this and all the horrible things the Chinese regime does to the Chinese people. But remember, China absolutely is not ready for democracy. Whew, this was a depressing episode. I think we should all take our minds off of it for a little while with a nice, relaxing trip to the movies. AMC Theaters, a proud subsidiary of Dalian Wanda Group.